Hey, what's up everybody, my name is Trophinet and welcome back to XCOM 2 in our Commander playthrough, where we're gonna try and complete the next mission with this squad. So a few of the guys that and girls that we don't really use all that often. I think it's the first time we actually take three female and three male soldiers with us. So Emma, completely leveled up. Then Jazz, who is one level away from max level. Then Geralt, our heavy that we've been using at the beginning of the series quite a bit, but have left behind in favor of Ulrich. And then Yang. Yang herself is coming along as well. Vinny, and then Jesse, who is our Psy operative. So yeah, Operation Crypt Queen, here we go. So if I'm not mistaken, I think I chose this mission because it's destroying a relay. And that's easier to do.
We're picking up a steady stream of communications coming from a hidden alien comm relay uploading data to the Advent network from this region. We have to take advantage of every opportunity to disrupt the aliens' progress on their latest operation. So we're moving in to destroy the relay before they complete the transfer. Don't leave any hostiles standing.
So it had a few reasons. So destroying an alien relay is usually one of the easier things to do. Then we also get a sharpshooter, an almost leveled up, fully leveled up sharpshooter, which would also be handy, especially since we don't really need any more supplies. Or an engineer, so yeah, that is handy as well. So District Gutter Station in Lagos. There we go, I'm really curious how this will pan out with these guys.
Metis 1-5, the communications relay is up ahead. Move in and destroy the target.
8 turns, I presume? Yeah, that shouldn't be too much of a problem. Let's use Jazz as our first scout. And I'll see you guys when anything happens. And there we go. Jazz spots a shield bearer, a trooper, and a codex.
Commander, that codex provides the ideal opportunity to infiltrate the Advent network. We will need to move in with the Skulljack to initiate the process.
And therefore we're gonna put Emma a bit closer, but I'll set this up and I'll see you guys in a second. Oh, and there's guys coming in from the left as well. That might be a problem. Although they're pretty, yeah, it's just a mech and a trooper, so that shouldn't be too much of a problem. I'm actually wondering, if you try and skull check from concealment, does that improve your odds or not? No, it does not. So I'm not gonna do that. The ideal situation would be that the Codex is pretty much the last thing left alive. Because as did happen with, well, skulljacking a commander, there's gonna be an extra unit on the field once we skulljack the Codex. So I do wanna be careful. Could try and hack it, but that's really, really risky at this point. I can slash pretty much everything, but I can't seem to kill anything with a slash. So that's not handy as well. Could start it off with a blaster bomb, killing pretty much everything in its radius. But then again, why would I? Vinny can't see the guys inside, which begs me to believe that I should set up this a bit further, so give me a second. So yeah, I'm just gonna try and attack these guys, because there's nothing really happening at the moment. Do I use an acid bomb? Because that would be ideal. It shouldn't kill... Oh, no, no, no. I'm gonna make a field that I can't pass through, so that is probably not the best idea. I could use her first shot, which is 100% from here, to take out most of the shield bearer's armor and health. So I think that's exactly what I'm gonna do. Because Yang has salvo right now, so she could do something else after this. Oh, and she even kills him. That is amazing. Okay. This is good. I'm gonna have to be careful. We're revealed, but I don't think anybody could see the mech from there. If they can, we're gonna be in a bit of a problem. No, okay, that's good. What I'm gonna do next is actually to immediately try and do what we came here to do. So I'm gonna skulljack the codex. I'm gonna do it from over here so that we get a better position if we, well, either if we fail or do this, we need a good position. So yeah, here we go. Oh gold, please make this work. Please make this work. Oh yeah. Access to the Avatar Project. Attempt an unauthorized network access of the Avatar Project. And then we can get a small intel cache or a large one. I'm gonna go for the small one. And we're not gonna get that, so we're gonna take a little bit of damage. And more importantly, right now, we're gonna have a bit of a problem. Because there is the Avatar.
I believe we are seeing something entirely new. An alien species that has so far managed to elude capture or observation by resistance forces. I strongly advise a cautious approach.
So I want to take a closer look at this guy. So this is an Avatar. I think it's even marked as one. Yeah, Avatar. So if you even show target details, you get, well, there's Avatar on top of its head if you want to check that out. So this is an Avatar. You see that it's already taken damage. That's because the health it has is based on how far the Avatar progress was at the time you hacked the codec. So that's very important to take into account. So what we want to do here is, I think, try and first use Yang, which I apparently cannot for some reason, which is weird. Never mind. I don't have the salvo ability on. So I'm gonna try and get closer here with Geralt and use his Shredstorm cannon to completely obliterate everything on its path. So Shredstorm cannon on the Avatar. Well, yeah, pretty much something like that. I'm gonna try and avoid killing civilians, but this should allow us to do quite a bit of damage.
Who wants some?
Well, the Avatar. Goodbye. Can't see how much it shredded, but I think everything is gone over there. So, as with the Codex, this thing can constantly teleport. Which is not that bad, because now we can use Vinny, if I'm not mistaken, and position ourselves to the other side of the truck and use his new fan hammer ability. There we go, fan fire. So yeah, the Avatar is also counted as an electronic, or not, he's not counted as an electronic enemy. That is interesting, but I'm gonna use fan fire to try and kill it. One, oh, wow. Well, goodbye.
Not too shabby.
So that was the Avatar. Yeah, not too shabby indeed. I'm gonna try and move a bit further as well. Maybe even try and... what can we do here? Soul fire. Not gonna kill it, so I'm just gonna try and do a flank shot on this trooper. And just shoot it in the face with an 89% shot. And that doesn't kill it. Sadly. We still have a few options left. We could, well, not a few, I just can try and slash it from over here, which is exactly what I'm going to do. So, yeah, slash. 99% should hit. Goodbye. Taken care of. So now we're probably gonna get attacked by the mech and the trooper inside the building. There we go, they're coming out. Although this guy's... ooh, what the frick. He can't handle stairs, apparently. Okay, so I think, if I'm not mistaken, Jazz has Shadow Step, so he doesn't trigger Overwatch. I could just use the blaster bomb. I'm gonna try it. Yeah, I don't have to select it. So normal grenades I need to select before I fire, because in the previous episode this just went off, because apparently you don't need to select it before trying to aim. Because if you use a grenade, you need to select it before you start aiming, but the blaster bomb just does it automatically. So this
calling in.
Should be pretty good. Blammo! Oh, that was weird. Kinda looked like it killed the mech, but apparently it just dropped down and I hear another mech. I can't fire from here, but I am going to put her on Overwatch if I can. Vinny, you are Colonel already. I know I can kill pretty much anything with you. But I do want to get somebody else some promotion, so
I'm on the move.
Let's put a few of these guys a bit closer to
on
try and take out at least a few guys.
Keep it.
So Jazz can't, of course, see anything, obviously. But I can slash the guy over here, so that's what I'm going to do next. And slash in the face, he's going around murdering people with a sword. Murdering aliens with a sword. Hopefully I didn't put him in a bad position there. No, okay. Fine by me, so Geralt. 73% on the mech. Let's try that. That was a nice hit. Thank you, Geralt. Thank you very much. And it's twitching out a bit.
Hostile target down.
Yeah, hostile target down indeed. And then, yeah, Vinny, I'm just going to move you up. So you can perform whatever you want to do in the next turn. There's something really close. It sounds like a sectopod even. So I'm just going to put everybody a bit closer in that direction.
I'm on it.
And some overwatches maybe might be handy as well. There we go. And Yang, yeah, just come closer as well because we're going to need you.
Not a problem.
There we go. Dropping down and getting a bit closer. So I'm using Jazz as a scout a bit here, because he's in concealment and he can see without triggering anything. So that seems like a shield bear, a lancer and a sectopod. Nothing in that group should pose a threat to us. But I do need to be careful that I start shooting at the relay in at last the next turn, because can Jazz actually shoot at the... Ooh, he can. From over there, that is interesting. So that window over there should also be a good position to be in. So if I just put everybody a bit closer to that position, I should get a nice shot at it in the next turn. I'm just going to try and put everybody closer. If I can't do anything useful... In this turn, that's not that bad, I think. Is, yeah, I do need to be careful that I don't trigger anything. From here, I can actually hack something. Ooh. That's not gonna work, is it? I could hack the pole. I'm just gonna check that for a second. Because I didn't really check those out just yet. So if I can do something like getting all my points back, that would be really, really nice. Soldier gains squad sight for 3 turns. That is a weird thing to do. Because I don't want reinforcements. It's 100%, but yeah. Don't know why you would want that. I could shoot at the sectopod probably from the... Oh, what? Oh, he saw the bot pass. And we're not in concealment anymore. Okay. Okay. Wait, they didn't. Did they spot us? They didn't spot us. So what the hell? What the hell was that even about? Okay, then that is very weird. So let's just put Yang over there and start putting a few of the guys on Overwatch, because
moving to Overwatch.
I'm on it.
I don't want to do anything too brash. And I hope they start... Oh, he's on top. There's the officer just busting through the door. Oh, snap. Through half of the building. And goodbye, Graze. Did that kill it? He's almost dead. Oh, and that's Emma's guardian ability that fired twice, but she missed the second time. And that's something? I think the officer is dead, yes. There's another group of enemies in there. Jesus Christ. Jesus Christ, what is going on?
Mr. Target.
There's stuff happening constantly. And there's the Sectopod. Is he gonna fire? What? Oh, you could make that a bit more clear that he could... Oh, shit. Is he gonna do that again? Spotted flanked enemy, okay. And he's gonna use his Overwatch shot to kill the Lancer, probably. Hey, you have a short sword strike against him as well, normally. Yeah, there we go. Goodbye. Holy shit. That was a bit weird. Maybe you should put them on... Yeah, shields. Okay. Well then. That was interesting. That was really interesting. Don't really know what the hell just happened, because it didn't seem like the group with the Sectopod saw us, because they weren't really running away to cover. But this is annoying. Do I have a shot at the Sectopod? I do. Which is good, because I can do lightning hands at first. I do want to get an acid bomb in there as well. So first things first. Acid bomb. See, I can't aim right now. I need to select it and then I can aim. I can get it over here, which is pretty much the best I can do at this time, because there's two shield bearers in here, by the way. That is hopefully gonna shred the armor, because I don't know what this an acid bomb will do with, well, with the shields. Okay, it shreds some armor. And yeah, it destroyed the shields as well, which is really good, because now I think I'm just gonna use the other acid bomb and fire away at them again. I can't get, yeah, okay. Just gonna do the same thing again, because that's I think the best option here. The blaster bomb would have been amazing, because I think I would have been able to destroy the entire building with it. But there we go, that's all their armor down. Then Vinny has a pretty good position to start firing at pretty much everything it can see. It's 79 with the pistol. So a lightning hand shot is definitely the first thing I'm gonna do. So that's 9 damage. And then what I could do is fire again. And that should allow us to still use the abilities we still have left. So if I just fire the pistol again. Another 10 damage. There we go. And then I get... I could try fanfire or I could go face off. And face off is gonna hit all these guys. Possibly, because it's 50-50 chances right now. So let's try that. That destroyed the Sectopod, which is really, really good. That hits actually the trooper on the right, because that goes EMP rounds go through shields, which is really good. We still have 2 turns left, so I think I'm just going to try and kill everybody in the building right now, because that's exactly what we're going to have to do. So Skull Mine. I'm gonna have to skull mine one of the full health guys. Although, I think if I'm smart about this, what does the plasma blaster do? Does that go... Oh. That looks like it hits the guy in front here as well. So plasma blaster, never you really use this thing. But it appears as though I can blast through the building inside of, well, 2 guys' face. So yeah, why not? Blammo! That looked amazing. It didn't hit the one in the front, but that does remove the shields from everybody. So, which is really, really good. Then I'm gonna try and skull jack. So skull mine the shield bear over here. Trying to give ourselves a bit of cover to do this from. So from through the window, probably that should be a good position. So skull mine. Please, please, please. Yes, we don't get the animation if it doesn't work. There we go. Failed hack will result in taking feedback damage. Yes, I know, but that doesn't care. We don't care. Enemy intel. There we go. That's two successful hacks in one mission. Well done, Emma. So that's one down, and then we have one guy left, which shouldn't be a problem if I just... Yeah, I'm just gonna go over here. Who do we have left, actually? Geralt. So Geralt could technically just bomb the place. But I'm just gonna move him a bit closer in a second and just try to clear ourselves a path towards that relay we need to destroy. There we go, 100%. Goodbye. 17 damage was a bit of overkill. But yeah. Wow, we got out of there. Pretty good. And I'm just gonna put Geralt over here so that we can fire on the relay in the next turn. And our last turn, by the way. Okay, and now Bradford is gonna complain.
Transmission signal is fading. They've almost completed the transfer. This is your last chance to take out that relay.
No biggie. I think I'm gonna just use Yang to get the loot over here.
Good to go.
There we go. She's gonna take that. Because I'm not really sure if we're gonna get it if I complete the mission. So just to be sure. Superior expanded magazine, advanced speed, and superior agility. That is pretty good. Pretty good indeed.
Asset secure.
Yes, and then we can... I think it's 100%, right? Yeah, we don't really need to aim at that. There we go, 9 damage, and then Geralt is gonna mop this up. Geralt, give me Geralt. Yeah, there we go. Goodbye, relay. See you in the next life. And that's the mission, I think, because I don't think there was anything else left. There we go.
Confirmed. Mission accomplished.
12 enemies killed, because we took out the Avatar as well. So that was a really productive mission. So just to be clear, Avatars are actually... Wow, 100% successful shot percentage. That's really good. Avatars are the answer to the Elder's affliction, because they take control of those Avatar bodies. And that's why we could see the mirage of an Elder behind the Avatar. And that's also the reason why we're going to see more of them, because there's not just one Avatar. They started making bodies for all of the Elders. Something is happening. Weird noises. That was a peculiar sound. How many promotions did we get?
To the highest end.
None.
Excellent work, Commander.
Okay then, never mind.
Commander, although I firmly believe the specimen we have recovered is crucial to the aliens' efforts, we currently do not have the means of properly studying it.
There we go, indicating another upgrade. So Avatar Corpse, this body exhibits no signs of decomposition, and initial scans show a disconcerting level of lower order brain activity. Reports of auditory hallucinations from the staff that handled this specimen are disturbing, but as yet they are unsubstantiated. So that's creepy. We get a lot of corpses, the loot, and a bit of intel, which is always handy. So use the shadow chamber to study the corpse of the summoned Avatar being that was killed in combat by XCOM forces. There we go. The aliens build an elaborate new society, a government structure, and a system of careful manipulation solely to fuel the creation of this, their so-called Avatar. At the cost of countless human lives, they have finally succeeded.
You have done an outstanding job leading the Resistance, Commander.
So we killed an Avatar, we reduced the Avatar progress by 2, and we countered the Dark Event Infestation. We also got a new sharpshooter, Joe Hayes. So there we go, Colonel Joe Hayes. So he is actually fully leveled up, which means I can actually go into the armory, check him out, and just level him up completely, because that's a colonel. That would be a hell of a lot of work to complete ourselves. So promote. And he actually gets rupture as well. Holy shit. A rupture shot deals critical damage. So that's from the heavy tree. And ensures that the target takes an additional +3 damage from all attacks in the future. Wow. So definitely squad sight. Yeah, you can't really choose that. Long watch. There we go. Deadeye. Take a shot with a small aim penalty. No, not really. He has a hell of a lot of aim, by the way. Lightning hands, it is. Then death from above. Kill zone. Steady Hands, I think, is a good one. And then, of course, Serial, so a fully fledged sniper. And that's gonna be a really cool guy here. Gonna check his weapon upgrades. Do we have an extra scope? We don't really have it. But we do have an expanded magazine we can spare, so there we go, you can have that. So there we go, another colonel added to the team, because we have 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8 colonels already, and 2 ready to get another promotion. It's sad that Yessie didn't get a promotion from that mission. She did kill at least one of them, but sadly that didn't go through. We are researching the Sionic Gate, so that's not really an issue. We didn't get an Elegium core, if I'm not mistaken. But yeah, with that done, we're gonna head towards the bridge and check out our Avatar project progress, because they're starting to fall apart completely. They're back to halfway progress.
Commander, having defeated this unknown entity, your troops have once again proven their dedication to our cause. Hopefully your team can uncover this being's connection to the Avatar project.
So we were building a radio relay over there. We're gonna do that now. Well, we're just gonna continue doing that.
Reading you loud and clear.
There we go, Vigilo Confido Commander. We will share your message of resistance across New Indonesia and beyond. So 67 supplies added to the supply drop, which will come in 9 days. And then, of course, we're gonna go to the Black Site data coordinates, and we're gonna make contact with New Australia first. There we go. And there we go, Sionic Gate research completed.
Hate to do this, but you're the only one who can pull this off. You know I'd go myself if I could.
The gateway is primed. Is the subject prepared?
Ready.
This is really funny.
I hardwired what was left of the codex.
Because it's just Rover.
It should be emitting the same signal the codex used to pass through the gateway.
Excellent. Let us begin.
Interesting. So they want to try and use a codex brain to enter the gate.
A similar rift in the field. I am sure your device will be fine.
So here we go. Rover entering the gateway and hopefully getting out in one piece.
There. We're set to record across all spectrums.
Remember, go in, take some quick readings, then come right back through, okay?
Here we go.
Whoa. Are you seeing this?
It appears our signal has been received. Increasing power.
Doesn't look like any place we've been before. Or any place on Earth, for that matter.
Perhaps this is the source. The aliens' seat of power, if you will. Secured beyond any physical limitations.
Only one way to find out.
Go, 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 Rover!
Go on. We're counting on you.
Here we go. And there it goes.
That is definitely not fine, Doctor.
The process did work. There was an instant where the device was in between locations. However, once that occurred, the gateway called for a second signature, an organic signature. When we could not provide one, it generated a sort of feedback pulse.
Obviously.
Yep.
If the codex creates the door, this organic signature must surely be the key.
Well, we better make sure we have the right key before we try again. I would hate for this to occur to something organic.
Agreed. I'll report our findings to the commander immediately.
I'm right here. Hello. You can talk to me directly. Although the logistical concerns involving in transporting a large piece of potentially unstable alien technology were difficult to manage, they are easily dwarfed by the risks involved in attempting to operate this device within the confines of the Avenger. Although Shen and I both had our concerns, given the directives of our operation, we saw little alternative but to begin experimenting on this gateway as soon as possible. After a period of slow, deliberate power increases accompanied by the appropriate level of monitoring, We felt comfortable enough to leave the gateway operating in its idle state. At that point, we conducted a series of simple tests on various objects to better understand how the aliens use the device for transportation. Initially, we saw no means of actually putting the gateway into an active state. That is to say, the gateway itself seemed to disregard or ignore the objects we passed through. Having studied the alien codex and its ability to open rifts in the field for deployment, we theorized the gateway might be tied to a similar signal or key integrated into the codex itself. Sure enough, by mirroring the frequencies found in close proximity to the codex, we found that the gateway itself enters a second active condition. Shen was hesitant to relegate her pet gremlin to use in our experiment, but she recognized the value in having a remote test subject, and we had no other units available to spare. Unfortunately, our initial theories as to the gateway's function overlooked the possibility that it was also tied to the biological components of the codex. Shen's personal gremlin suffered some relatively minor damage during our test, but its sacrifice led to an important revelation in terms of how we might access this gateway and discover its source. So there we go, we need to, provide an organic signature as well, indicating that whoever goes through the gateway needs to perform the codex signal and be an organic creature of, the same signature that the gateway expects. So let's review the upgrade. We need to upgrade it for 200 supplies and we need 4 power to do so. So we can't just do that just yet. So I'm going to go to research for now and see what we can do here. We still have a few left. And I think I'm just going to go for the Gatekeeper Autopsy, because the Berserker Autopsy isn't all that interesting. Could go for the datapad as well to get a bit more intel, but I'm going to go for the Gatekeeper Shell first.
This specimen, referred to as the Gatekeeper, seems to harbor considerable psionic power. As with the alien's other unique biomechanical field unit, it will take some time to decipher the systems involved in its function.
So that's why this thing is not a robot, because you can see there's a meat pack inside, which is extremely gross. But with that done, let's head back to the bridge. Yeah, sorry, Tigan. Can't really do anything about that if you're just gonna do that. So continue making contact with New Australia then. And another psionic training complete. So domination, permanently mind control an enemy. Let's continue the training and choose something else. Grant a bonus action immediately to a nearby squad mate. The Psy operative is surrounded by an aura that immediately extinguishes or blocks any mental impairments for themselves and any nearby squad mates. I think I'm just going to go for Inspire. There we go. Dark event complete. The aliens are on high alert, making it harder for XCOM to catch them unaware. So that means the radius of their sight radius when we're in concealment will have been increased for the next month. And another training complete, so Zoltan is our new Grenadier. Let's carry on and maybe even put somebody else in there. We still have a few guys left. Soldier required, yes I know, do something. Maybe put Donald Trump in there and put him as a Grenadier as well, because we have plenty of everything else. And we can always use more Grenadiers. And then finish the contact. Which means that next up we're going to do the Black Site Coordinates mission, because that will reduce the Avatar progress even further and of course, get us some new supplies.
We've made aside from contact with the resistance operatives working in this area, Commander. They're going to show us how to get into the Alien Forge facility.
And we get the Spy Ring bonus, so all intel rewards are increased by 25% from now on, which is really good, of course. I am wondering, we can't put another relay over here, so that means we're gonna have to go over here with probably 80 intel. Yeah, we don't have that just yet, so we can't make contact with the next region. We only need to make contact with 4 regions anymore, which is really, really good, although there might be another region over here, I'm not actually sure. I don't think there is, actually, but it should, yeah, we'll see about that. So next up, the Black Site Coordinates mission. We're gonna check that out right now. So 14 enemies. Heavy Mech, Elite Shieldbearer, Sectopod Andromedon, Elite Lancer, Sectoid, Elite Officers, and that's pretty much everything. So Important to note, no Vipers, no Archons, and generally, no, well, not that many organic units. So what we're gonna go with is mostly EMP rounds, and of course EMP bombs. So I'm gonna launch this. Yeah, there we go. And we're gonna take, always an interesting decision. I will want to go with two grenadiers. That's something I'm just gonna do. So Ulrich, put him back in here, and clear out utility items. Yes, and clear out armor. That should be enough. I'm gonna keep Emma in for now. Jazz is fine by me. Although I'm a bit hesitant about what I want him to shoot with. Because if he could go with EMP rounds instead of Talon rounds, that could benefit us more than just, yeah, I'm just gonna go with blue screen rounds. There we go. Let's keep the Mimic Beacon on him, and I'm just gonna give him the advanced speed PCS, because with the sword that's gonna be really, really handy. And then I'm gonna just set up everybody else, so give me a second. So yeah, this is gonna be the team we're gonna head out with. I know it's a pretty heavily leveled team, but we're getting really close to the ending of the game as well, so I don't think it matters all that much anymore. So Emma, Jazz, Ulrich, Yang, Vinny, and Hugh. I brought back Hugh because of the healing. With the 14 enemies, we're gonna need some healing probably. So yeah, that's what we're gonna head in with, into Operation Frozen Father. Where we're gonna investigate the Advent Forge. But that's gonna have to wait until next episode. For now, I'd like to thank you all for watching. If you enjoyed the episode, don't forget to like it right here on YouTube. And if you haven't already, don't forget to subscribe to my channel, because I'd really appreciate any support you guys can give me. So thanks again, Anansi, for watching, and I hope to see you in the next video or series. Goodbye!